إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت وهو على كل شيء قدير. يا رب لك الحمد، أنت نور السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت قيوم السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، ولك الحمد أنت ملك السماوات والأرض وما فيهن، أنت الحق ووعدك حق ولقاؤك حق والجنة حق والنار حق. وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا رسول الله، نشهدك يا ربنا أنه قد بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة، فكشف الله تعالى به عن هذه الأمة الغمة، وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فاللهم صل وسلم وزد وبارك على هذا النبي الأمي الأمين وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته واقتفى أثره وسار على دربه إلى يوم الدين. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله، وخير الهدي هدي نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة في دين الله بدعة. أما بعد، فعن سيدنا عبد الله بن عباس رضي الله عنهما قال: قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ما من أيام العمل الصالح فيهن أحب إلى الله من الأيام العشر. قالوا: يا رسول الله، ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله؟ قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم: ولا الجهاد في سبيل الله إلا رجل خرج بنفسه وماله فلم يرجع من ذلك بشيء. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, Jumu'ah Mubarakah, may Allah bless all of you, inshallah. Inshallah, from tomorrow, we will start the first 10 days in Dhul Hijjah. The best 10 days in the whole year. As the hadith I mentioned now, narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma. And when I say radiallahu anhuma, because he is Sahabi and his father is Sahabi, Sayyidina Abdullah ibn al-Abbas. Al-Abbas is the uncle of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's why when the Sahabi and his father is Sahabi, you say radiallahu anhuma, not anhu, both of them. He said that Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith that the whole year, there is no any best or better days in the whole year more than the first 10 days in this month, Dhul Hijjah. The whole year. And al-amal, if you are doing something for sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in these 10 days, you can't compare the reward by any other 10 days in the whole year. Even the Sahaba asked Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even if we are doing jihad, you see, even if you are doing jihad, al-amal in these 10 days, even much better than jihad itself. You can imagine? That's a hadith narrated by Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. And other hadith also mentioned in the Musnad Imam Ahmad, he just add that you should increase at-takbir and tasbih and tahleel. This is the Nasr hadith. Imam Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani, Amir Mu'min hadith of course, he said, why these 10 days are very special? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us a chance to gather the main ibadat which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Like what? Think by your mind. In these 10 days, what kind of ibadat we are doing? Fasting? And sadaqah? And praying? And hajj? All of those four main things in what? In the 10 days. Even in Ramadan, we are doing fasting, we are doing prayer, we are doing salah, but not hajj. But in these 10 days, we are doing fasting and salah and sadaqah and hajj. That's why it's very special. And if it is special for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He made qasam in Surah Al-Fajr. He said, وَالْفَجْرِ وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ. Several sahaba and tabi'in, in the tafsir of this Surah Al-Fajr, they say, وَلَيَالٍ عَشْرٍ is the 10 days of Dhul Hijjah. Some sahaba said like that in the tafsir. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when He make qasam, swear by something, it must be something very valuable, high ranking. And if it's very important, it should be important also for you as a Muslim. Not to be in the same attitude before the 10 days and after 10 days. Nothing changes for you. Come to the masjid, go out from the masjid, same akhlaq, same manner, same deeds before 10 days and after 10 days. It's not acceptable. If it's very special and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make qasam in Quran by these 10 days, and Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in many hadith spoke about those 10 days, is that not giving any sign for us to take it very serious? Sayyidina Sa'id ibn Jubayr from At-Tabi'in, he was doing his best, and other Sahaba and other Tabi'in doing their best in these 10 days. Why? Because he said the reward in these 10 days, you can't even imagine. I give you one hadith. That hadith has reported by Al-Imam al-Bayhaqi. Isnad is not sahih, but is not also da'if. Isnad, the isnad of the hadith, is not very high rank, but also not da'if. It can be accepted. That Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he spoke about those 10 days in Dhul Hijjah, he said, Siyam, fasting one day from the first day until 9. Because of course you can't fasting the day number 10, because it will be Eid. Yawm al-Nahar, you can't fasting, it's haram. But from the first day until day of 9. One day, the fasting of one day equal fasting 1,000 days. This as mentioned in the hadith. Can you imagine? I'm not speaking about the day of Arafah itself. From the first day until the 9. Take off day of Arafah 9, you can speak from the first day until 8. One day, fasting one day, in those 8 days, equal one day, equal 1,000 days. This is the hadith. Yawm Arafah is special, is more than this. Some narrations by Sayyidah Aisha radiallahu anha, and other narrations also according to Imam al-Bayhaqi, especially the hadith mentioned by Imam, by Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu, said the day of Arafah, fasting day of Arafah, equal 10,000 days. And if you speak about Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, then fasting day of Arafah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive the sins for the last year and next year. 2 years, last year and next year, just in one day. Plus, from the first day until day number 8, if you are fasting, every day equal 1,000 day, which 8,000 days, plus forgiving your sins in the last year and the next year. just 9 days. Just 9 days. It's big deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you very high chance. Take it or leave it. It's up to you. You are the person who decides. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving us very special days, and he make qasam in Quran, and he say also in Surah Al-Baqarah, in Surah Al-An'am, وَيَذْكُرُ اللَّهَ فِي أَيَّامٍ مَعْلُومَاتٍ and أَيَّامٍ مَعْدُودَاتٍ. Speak about many times, especially in verses and in ahadith about those special days. This about Siyam. Of course, when you speak about good deeds, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us especially the things he made it obligatory for you. If we speak about even 5 daily prayers, if you can pray it in the masjid, it's much better than doing your best in 1 or 2 days and not praying inside the masjid. And highly recommended, Salatul Fajr. Salatul Fajr. The masjid is empty in Salatul Fajr. Not here in Japan also. In other countries, even our countries as Muslim countries. Salatul Fajr, our masajid is empty. Even though same people who given excuses, say I was asleep, I was like this, I was like, same people, if they have job and the salary is very high, they will wake up every day. Wallahi, they will wake up every day. Same people, if they have good job and that job giving very high salary, they will wake up every day and they will do it. Why? Because there is high salary. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving you order to pray Fajr in Jama'ah, people are sleeping. And after they are sleeping, they say, why? What happening in Palestine happening? Of course, because of us. First, we should even perform the 5 daily prayers in the masjid first, before we speak about anything. Then, Salah in Jama'ah is obligatory actually for every Muslim. Except if you have excuse in your work or your study or whatever, okay, no problem. But if there is no excuse, you must pray in the masjid as a man. And I'm speaking about Fajr because Fajr and Isha, we have hadith speaking about the signs of Al-Munafiq. Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are 2 heavy prayers for the Munafiq. Very heavy for him. Fajr and Isha. Everyone check himself. I will check myself, you check yourself. Fajr and Isha. If it's heavy for the person to perform Fajr and Isha in Jama'ah, then he has to reconsider about himself again. Fajr and Isha. If the person see it's heavy for him to perform Fajr and Isha, especially in Jama'ah, he has to reconsider about himself again. Think again. What's wrong with you? What's wrong between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You have to check. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ولي الصالحين وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله الصادق الوعد الأمين عليه أفضل الصلاة وأتم التسليم. أما بعد، فيا عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي المذنبة بتقوى الله تعالى. One of the main things which mentioned Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim that Sayyidina Abdullah ibn Umar and Sayyidina Abu Huraira in these 10 days they are going to the market as-suq in Arabic and start to make takbir. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, La ilaha illallah, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, wa lillahi alhamd. Why? To make the people in the market remember about that and start also make takbir in the whole 10 days. This is like sunnah from Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to make takbir in these 10 days. Either by yourself or by people, whatever you want, but just make takbir. Of course, one of the main things in the day of Arafah, and remember this hadith, Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the best thing I said, me and the other prophet who came before me, لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. This is the best thing I said. Not him only, him and all other prophets before. again try to memorize it. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. This dua, if you could repeat it much in the day of Arafah, it will be inshallah very like big deal with you inshallah. Try your best to repeat that dua, especially in day of Arafah. Special dua for Arafah. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير. Of course, some people who try to again and again to understand the hadith and Quran by themselves. Some of them they will come to say, Sheikh, I see hadith in Sahih Muslim that Umm al-Mu'min Aisha رضي الله عنها said سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't do fasting of the 10 days of Zulhijjah. Yes, the hadith is sahih. But who told you are faqih and you are imam and you will take this hadith by yourself? Who told you? You have to check all the hadith together. Because if you see, check Sunan Abi Dawood and other hadith speaking about سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم